Hello friends, this video clip is about yarn numbering systems. In previous video clip, I have given brief information, little bit knowledge on English count, denier and tex. Now in this video clip, I'm going to share you some little bit knowledge on metric count. This metric count is used usually for coarser woolen count, coarser woolen yarn. Say the woolen jackets, woolen rugs, woolen made. Not worsted, not suitings or shedding quality wool yarns. Whatever I'm talking is for woolen made coarser yarns. Woolen made coarser yarn wool products, that is rugs, woolen jackets, other things, courses. Okay, see. Woolen tweeds, okay, so many things are there, I will come below. See, metric count, in English count, that is any, is used for measuring the yarns made of staple spinning, that is cotton, linen, even polyester, that is staple fibers, that is used, 20s count, 30s count and 40s count, and denier is also used for measuring the fineness of polyester yarn, nylon yarn, silk. Those are all made of the filament yarn, you know, yarns are of processed into from filament yarn and staple yarn. Denier, tex are used for filament yarns, and English count is used for cotton count, English count or cotton count, and the linen count is also there. Here, metric count, today I am going to give a brief explanation on metric count. This metric count is expressed, the unit of measurement, the symbol used is mm. This is metric count. What this metric count comes under indirect system. What direct system is saying? Direct system is expressed in terms of mass per unit length. But indirect system is length per unit mass. In direct system, the length is fixed. Whatever we are getting result, that is in grams, that is a denier, tex or whatever it is, that is direct system. But in indirect system, the mass. Here, in indirect system, unit length is there, 840 yards, and weight is fixed. Here weight is fixed and length is varying. In English count, indirect system, 1 pound, that is 454 grams, is fixed. whatever the number of length is there, that is multiple of 840 yards. One 840 yards weighing 1 pound, that is one count. Say multiple of 840 yards weighing in 1 pound, that is a count. Okay, like that. In metric count, what metric count is defining? 30,000 meters of yarn. 30,000. One, I'm saying here, 1 nm. 1 nm, one metric count equal to 30,000 meters. 30,000 meters weighing 1 kg. 30,000 meters, 1,000 meters equal to 1 kilometer. 30,000 meters equal to 30 kilometer. Okay, 30 kilometer. So, 30 kilometer or 30,000 meters of yarn weighing 1 kg equal to 1 metric count. Okay, understand? 30,000 meters weighing 1 kg equal to 1 metric count. Shall we go for 5 metric count? Okay. 5 into 30,000 meters. 30,000 meters. Correct. 5 into 30,000 meters weighing 1 kg. Weighing 1 kg equal to 5 metric count. Shall we go for further? Shall we go for 10s? 10 metric count. 10 times of 30,000 meters weighing 1 kg. Okay, shall we go for further? 15 metric count. 50 times of 30,000 meters weighing 1 kg. Weighing 1 kg is 50 metric count. Is this enough to understand the difference? Usually in woolen mills, whatever the woolen fabric of coarser count is usually of 10 metric count or 6 metric count, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12. In this range, they are using for coarser. The jackets, tweed, jackets made of tweed wool fabrics or brown wool, black wool. Okay, those are all coarser count. The jackets used for winter seasons. For winter seasons or cold climates, they are using. It's a quite heavy thickness. And also the GSM of the fabric, and the weight of the fabric is minimum of 400 GSM, 500 GSM. It will range from in that range. To make a fabric of 400 to 500 GSM, definitely the yarn used in warp and weft are of 10 metric count of 8, 9, 7, 6, like that it's required. Okay, so this is enough to understand 50. Is it? Now we come. Now we'll analyze. Say in all 1 metric count, 5 metric count, 10 metric count, and 50 metric count, in all these 4 counts, there are 4 yarns are there. There are 4 fineness are there, 4 thickness of the yarn. There are 4 yarns of different fineness or different thickness or different diameters, whatever you think. All are weighing 1 kg only. This is also weighing 1 kg, this is also weighing 1 kg, this is also weighing 1 kg, this is also weighing 1 kg. Okay, but the length are different. In this 30 kilometer is there. In this 30 into 5, 150 kilometer is there. In this 30 into 10, 300 kilometer is there. In this 30 into 5, 1500 kilometer is there. 1500 kilometer of yarn weighing 1 kg. 30 kilometer of yarn is weighing 1 kg. Now, which is coarser? Which is thicker? Which is finer? This become 1 kg. 30 kilometer yarn weighing 1 kg is coarser than 1500 meter of yarn weighing 1 kg. Definitely. Right? So this is a coarser. This is a finer. Right, metric count. Here, this metric count, hope you understood the fineness of the yarn, measurement of the fineness of the yarn, hope you understood. This is the finer side, okay. Usually, what are the woolen mills in India? Ludhiana, Bilwara, these are the areas producing woolen fabrics, okay, in India, I'm saying. If they are supplying yarns or using the yarns in the fabric in this metric range. Okay, not only here, even this metric count can be used for linen also, or can be used for other count also. Hope you understood. Now, if you go for woolen for suiting shirting qualities, woolen can worsted count is used. That is for, I will come in the next video clip, okay, regarding I will discuss on worsted count for shootings and shirtings. Okay. I'm repeating, there are in yarn numeric system, there are 2 systems are there. One is direct system and another is indirect system. Direct system is based on mass per unit length, and indirect system is based on length per unit mass. Indirect system, length is fixed. In indirect system, weight is fixed. Okay, both are weighing in a testing lab, testing under the lab condition means 65 plus or minus relative humidity RH and 23 degree centigrade temperature, and under moisture regain percentage required. Oven dry regain, it's maintaining main to maintain the yarn, it should be regain, should be controlled. Moisture regain will be controlled, zero moisture regain. It should be dry regain is required. If it is a moisture present in the yarn, if moisture is present in the sample, then that will not give a correct values. Hope you understood on this. I'll come with the other video clip on other linen count, worsted and woolen count. Please subscribe my channel. Please share to your friends, your students, those who are working in college, in the industries, mills, garment industries, okay, wherever, and also students of diploma, engineering, M.Tech, B.Tech, or JOC, whatever, handloom technology, whatever, please share and subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you. This is my institute, Sri Mati Manikeshwari tutorials. I am also taking class on primary schools and high schools, especially the mathematics. Mathematics is my interesting subject. And also I have other channels, Sri Mati Manikeshwari tutorials. You can visit this if you would like to. Thank you.